I don't know. I would not say I want to align with the government, but I think, in my own opinion, that the U.S. got it right, got it wrong, rather. I don't believe that any, particularly the two major religions in Nigeria, have been restricted in any way. As a matter of fact, they have become, apart from government, which is a behemoth, in my own opinion, the two of them have become the two greatest problems of this country. They are so free in practicing their religion that we have some self-appointed policemen of God in Kano moving from house to house looking for sinners. You come to the south, they block roads anyhow they like. They do their conventions anywhere. They shout at you from their megaphones. The only religions that are oppressed in Nigeria, perhaps, are people like us who still believe in the African traditional religions. We don't have our public holidays. When Muslims have their Fridays and Sundays, we don't have our Christmas. Even if you say it, people laugh at you. You know, people still mock us and disdain us. They stigmatize us like HIV patients. Like COVID-19 patients. This is when you say I'm an African traditionalist. So if it is Nigeria has been blacklisted for persecuting African traditional religions, I would say they got it right. But if it is Christianity and Islam, I will tell you that they are on the loose in Nigeria. They are out of the manacles and they are creating as much problem as government in Nigeria. They are so free. They are so out of control in Nigeria that all of us are worried how exactly we are going to be able to deal with it. Talk about terrorism, I will agree. We have been so terrorized, we are number three. But the connection with religion, yeah, somewhere, somehow, but I don't see how somebody would tell me that one religion or the other has been persecuted in Nigeria, except the African traditional religion. But for the two major religions, they are having the best of their time in Nigeria, both the Muslims and the Christians, as a matter of fact. They will come knocking our doors every day, stalking us, infringing on our own rights to religion and telling us that they want us to accept their own gods. Every day they have the audacity to call our African gods demons and idols. And somebody say they are not free. And then if you call their own gods demons, they tell you you're on your way to hell. As a matter of fact, for the two major religions, none of them is persecuted in Nigeria, if you ask me. It's just that we lack the capacity to enforce law and order on their excesses. If anybody is persecuted, I repeat again, if any religion is persecuted, it is those of us who belong to the African traditional religion. And if it is on that plank that the U.S. is blacklisting Nigeria, right, then they got it right. But if it is for the two major religions, nobody is being persecuted in Nigeria.